Oh, they're actually late on the tombstone. Lift gets way too close. And he's going to be caught out here. Should be dined. Yoki's right. Clicks a little bit of heal there. Aloha Dance does have another TK, which will finish him off. And they get the Light Striker right in Aloha Dance. He does end up dying, but Hanskin is now going to fall again here. A little bit of heal up. Landing Light Striker Ray. Nicely placed by Hanskin. And that will actually win it. Yoki goes down to the tower.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
A gift from the goddess.
Dragon's bottom tower is under attack.
I thought I was dead.
Oh, easy words.
Attack.
Too many irons in the fire.
Well, that'll teach you to hold still.
Little tower is
I
under
could
attack.
Provide an additional stun. Well, here you go. who needs a blink dagger when it's...
Quap's Ags is nice, obviously, but you get Lina Ags, and that just totally counters silent.
Yoki puts himself in the corner while Era gets that resolution kill. Era perhaps thinking about going for more. You know, some fun. Well, they're not going to catch him, but Hanskin is going to be found. As he tries to TP out, do they have enough damage? Ultimate popped, and there it is. Gyrocopter gets the last hit.
You actually try to build damage. I mean, I almost feel like you've got to... try to build damage. You got to win a fight somehow.
There's too much AoE clear for you to not go for it. They're going to try and go for the kill onto Era here, and they get it. In fact, they will. A right click should do the trick. In fact, the stun goes out. That is a huge amount of gold.
Oh, my Lord.
That is monster.
Suddenly SNY done on the gyro. You were calling for it, by the way. Boy, but this is where things get really hard because now Era, another 1K or so, a little bit more off his BKB. And once they have the BKB on Era and the Ags on Nightstalker, they can take fights really.
They've got all of Ninjas in Pajamas on the way, but they may be able to get the quick kill on Hanskin. In fact, you see the rest of Nip quickly retreating.
On Zeus is that people underestimate the damage that Zeus can do just by standing close to a fight with that static field, as you were talking about earlier.
Smoke's going to pop here. They pop the ultimate, not catching. Oh, they do catch him.
They may have Era.
This is going to be a big one. They try and lock down the big beast, but he pops BKB. Turning to fight, Empire do not have the physical damage, but they're slowing him down pretty damn well, especially with the tombstone on the cliff. Era kited around perfectly. They get that one kill. The trade-off is going to be the Jakiro. The zombies chasing down Seal Kid. They should be able to get an additional win on him with Resolution cleaning him up. Yoda Symphon also going to be pushed back here, and Empire may have the opportunity to take Roshan here with that win.
Yeah, I mean, anytime you look at a net worth graph and it's flat, it's such an advantage for the team that's behind.
Oh, always want to fly, going to be picked off here, but Good setup here. Ice Bath already laid down. Era comes in, but he's going to be slowed down. Look at that. The BKB plus the Tombstone. Era going straight for the Tombstone. They don't finish off the Undying. He's going to be able to come back in. Era dropping low. He's going for the kill into the zombie. Will just barely be able to help out Yonosabani. He's not going to get it either. They give away that Aegis now surrounding the Queen of Pain. Laid out the Ice Bath, and that is a total wipe. Ninjas of Pajamas, all they claim is a vengeful spirit. And that is now Empire 100% back in this game on even footing. Yeah, he's over 2,000 gold ahead of the Tiny, and gonna be even more as they take this tier 3 tower. Ninjas in Pajamas don't think they can really fight me. This could be straight up them losing the game if they get caught here without the Tiny. Pop the BKB, Jonas and Fon's gonna be fine. What a brilliant ice path from Seal Kid, and that is actually really gonna save the fight as both of these heroes are gonna end up falling here. They go for the Tombstone at the same time. Seal Kid gonna go down. Jonas and Fon being chased by zombies. This should to be able to survive, but Silent just ripping through hero after hero is now gonna be able to pop the BKB. Backs away though, as Tiny comes back, he doesn't commit for the range.
Now that's the downside of the build that Yunusimphan has gone in this game, that without the Orchid or the Sheepstick on his Queen of Pain, they just don't have the tools to control.
They're pushing out the tier 3 tower at the same time. Nipper gonna lose the fight in middle lane, but look at all the damage on the tier 3. It's already down. Hanskin trying to TP out. Always want to fly though. Does just
swap.
Thanks to always want to Wave of Terror and always want to fly. Well, he lives through the Laguna Plane. They're also trying to chase down Arrow. Looks like he was forced into the BKB again, the utility factor from Yoki. He hit the Yield Scepter, I think. Oh, the turnaround Arrow. Gonna miss out the Avalanche. Yoki actually banked aggressively forward, and now Arrow could potentially lose on this. Yoki goes right through the trees. Yield Scepter out. Ice Path forward. He's just trying to stall up time. That way Zeus can finally get here. Macro Pyre stalling up Arrow. And Era does not have a TP scroll. There's no real way out for him except for a Blink Dagger. Zeus pops the ultimate, making sure they still see Era keep that Blink Dagger alive. And Era is going to go down inside of this jungle. Nicely set up. Resolution blinks forward into it because he knows he's fine.
That is your three-position Jakiro, half the net worth of Tiny, who's able to just completely control Era long enough for his team to get their unbelievable plays here by Empire.
It seems like that may be a necessity in situations like that.
Dire's top tower. Yeah, I mean, this is, it sounds obvious, but this is the downside of the Tiny without the Wisp. And boy, Empire just had this match by the throat.
Lina already using the offensive Yule's. Not going to have any defense against that setup. We already have the Queen of Pain going for resolution. The swap out causing a bit of confusion. Jonas and Fon forced away. Aloha Dots in the back. Ninja's pajamas are pursuing for him, but now the turnaround is Empire quickly go inside the base, take down three, and Era sitting like a cuckold in the back, waiting and waiting and waiting, but Empire just dominating the rest of the team of Nip.
Silent is just an animal. We talked about him kind of moving out of that hard one role, but showing in a couple of recent matches that he can still dominate games just like anybody. Man, what a player.
Yeah, Aloha Dance going to be caught, Empire. Are going to lose one here, but doubt they're going to lose much more as Era's BKB is going to run out. They're not going to continue to go for the Sonic Wave actually takes out that Vengeful Spirit, the Yule Scepter, set up to the Ice Path. Jonas Amon does not have a BKB and will end up dying a secondary time here. Zeus actually popping the Refresher, could get the kill on Era, but Era gets the toss first and should be able to get out. Yoki trying to pursue. No, he stops that Blink Dagger. Era's not going to get out. He ends up falling a second time, and that is going to be Silent. He's got whatever he wants to do. He can go for the tier 4s. He can go for the Raxes. Doesn't matter because there's no one on the side of Nip that can stop
Dire's
him now.
Top tower is
747 gold per minute. 14-0-7. Silent putting on a show.
Dire's top barracks are under
26
attack.
26-27. Unbelievable. It was, what, 1-19 at some point in time? Somewhere in there. Silent. Yeah. They're going to start going on him with the buybacks. Ninjas in Pajamas need to be able to bait out this BKB for a while and land the stunts necessary, but they've already lost the Ribbon, and they're about to lose the Lina too. Silent cleans that up. The help of resolution. Jonas Afan also going to be slowed down by the Rod of Atos, and GG well played. Ninjas in Pajamas, they got to be feeling so bad about game number 3 that's coming up, because they just went from what was a 10,000, almost 12,000 gold lead by 20 minutes to losing this game, going in by 35-40. It felt like Empire had already taken control of the game.
Unbelievable. I mean, it was 18-1 in kills, and it finishes 29-27. Just an unreal comeback by Empire, and it boils down to Nip not having enough control.